Hey, what's going on, guys? Ted Carr here from Fruit Living, and I want to give you the 5 tips that fitness newbies make. People new in the fitness game, they want to get fit and healthy, so they go to the store, they buy some shoes, they buy a bike, they forget to buy a helmet, they go out biking, they crash. No, but get a helmet before you go riding, get some good shoes before you go running, but first watch this video and learn from it. So, first tip people make when they get into fitness game is they don't first focus on recovery. You've got to focus on your recovery first. If you're not recovered, how are you supposed to have the energy to want to eat properly and then go out and push your body to the maximum? You know, if you don't get proper sleep, you're not going to be motivated. The easiest way for me to lose my motivation when it comes to training is by not getting enough sleep. If I don't get enough sleep one night, I wake up and I'm not motivated really. You've got to have full rest if you want to have full motivation. So that's the first thing. Focus on your recovery. Not just sleeping at nighttime, but also taking naps during the day. And not just sleeping when you're tired at nighttime, but getting to bed before you're tired. So that's huge. The second thing is nutrition. Once you get enough sleep, once you're fully recovered, you're going to be able to eat properly. You're going to have an actual appetite. And when it comes to eating properly, that means fruits. That means lots and lots of fruits. If you're not eating fruits as the staple calorie source, then seriously, what are you eating? What is healthier than fruit? The only thing I could think of was like some cooked fruit, like some pumpkins or starches or something like that. Yeah, cooked rice is all right, cooked potatoes is all right. Just as long as you're focusing on the carbohydrates when it comes to athletics, that's going to be key. But fresh fruit always wins the day. Fresh fruit always wins first place. Fruit is king, man. Fruit is number one. Fresh, juicy fruit. Bananas, mangoes, papayas, oranges, dragon fruits, sweet, juicy fruits, pineapples, watermelons, these sorts of things. Make this your number one fuel source. So that's nutrition. A lot of newbies, they get into this and they focus on eating just whatever and whatever just for calories. No, don't focus on calories. Focus on sweet, high quality, juicy fruit. And then you'll have really good fuel in your system and your Lamborghini to go hammer away. Third thing people make a mistake about is they're not consistent enough. And they expect the results to come within 2 months. They expect the results to come in 3 months. I'll tell you what. The real results come when you're consistent for at least a year or two. At least a year or two. That's when you start to see yourself running sub 20-minute 5Ks. You start to see yourself being able to hold, you know, 4 watts per kilo for 5-10 minutes. After 1 to 2 years of consistent training, you're going to be seeing good results with your running, with your swimming, with your cycling, with your strength training. But give yourself that 2 year window. Really give yourself that 2 year window to see some big changes. And then if you want to be the best, if you want to be like a professional, man, give yourself 7 to 10 years. You got to give yourself 7 to 10 years if you want to be a professional in any sport. If you want to be the fittest man alive, fittest woman alive, give yourself 7 to 10 years to really build up that consistency. If you do too much too soon, without having that consistent base, then you're gonna blow up, you get injured, and that sort of thing. And being consistent doesn't mean being consistent with just one sport. It means just doing anything. Just be consistently moving your body every day. Either going for big walks or big little runs. Don't need to go for big runs. Being on the elliptical, being in the weight room, swimming, biking, doing anything. Just be consistently moving your body. Going for hikes, whatever. Just be consistent. And then once you've been consistent long enough, then you can move on to the next stage. And the next mistake a lot of people make is, yeah, they're not consistent, but then the next mistake they make is they're not specific enough. They don't get specific enough. And what I mean by that is, you know, they maybe go to the gym a lot and they do a lot of push-ups, or they do a lot of bench press or whatever, or they swim a lot to get good cardio, but then they enter a bike race and they're like, how can I perform that well in my bike race? It's because you didn't bike specifically enough for the bike race. And they're like, okay, well, so the next time they come along, they just bike, but they don't get really specific enough for that bike race. So they just bike whatever, bike would go long bike rides. But the bike race may be something really short and intense, like a short, hard hill, 30-minute hill climb or something. You've got to train specifically for that hill climb. So once you've been consistent, once you have that big base built, then start getting really specific and train for, you know, your singular sport or that singular race that you're training for. Get specific with the intensity, get specific with the the technique and all that sort of thing. Be specific. Don't just be general and expect to get amazing results. Specify, narrow in. And then the last mistake people make, the fifth mistake people make, is they don't push the intensity enough. They don't push the intensity enough. Yeah, they're consistent for years, and yeah, they even get really specific and train specifically for a race, but then they're too scared to pump up the intensity. And these are the people who, they don't take it to the next level, and they just pretty much stay the same forever. You've gotta push the intensity, but only, notice how it comes at the very end, only push the intensity once you're fully recovered, once you've been eating properly, once you've been consistent long enough, and once you've specifically narrowed in on your sport, once you've specifically narrowed in on what you want to get good at, then you push the intensity. Don't do the intensity first. Don't wake up and just put in P90X and go hard. So those are my five tips. Hope you got something in this video. I really rushed it. The battery has been flashing this whole time, so this is gonna die any second now. Appreciate you guys watching this, and if you have any questions, post them down below. I'll make another video regarding those. I just want to get this off my head into the video form for you to enjoy and take away. Focus on recovery, guys, and then focus on nutrition, and then be consistent with whatever, and then start getting specific before you push the intensity. That's it. Peace. That's the recipe, baby. Time to ride.